The current time is 3:50 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Two tornadoes in Leon County now rated low end F1 intensity.
Here we go.
National Weather Service damage survey for 01/27/21 tornado event. Update number 2, overview. Two tornadoes touched down in Leon County on Wednesday morning. The first was only on the ground briefly, but caused F1 damage to a property on Bluntstown Highway. The other was a longer track tornado, primarily of F0 strength. There was one small area of F1 damage at Tallahassee International Airport.
I want to hit one to Tallahassee, try to catch it.
Rating, F1 estimated peak wind 90 miles per hour path length, or statute /0.8467 miles path width, or maximum /50.0 yards fatalities, 0 injuries, 0 start date, January 27, 2021 start time, 11:30 Eastern Standard Time start location, 1 Southwest Fort Braden, or Leon County, or Florida start Lapland, 30.4182, or -84.55.22 end date, January 27, 2021 end time, 11:31 Eastern Standard Time end location, 1 SSW Fort Braden, or Leon County, or Florida and Lapland, 30.4196, or -84.53.81 survey summary. A tornado initially touched down on Oscar Harvey Road, snapping some treetops. The tornado then did damage consistent with an F1 rating at Bluntstown Highway and Siebes Road. Several large live oak trees were uprooted and several outbuildings were destroyed. Winds peaked around 90 miles per hour in this area. The tornado lifted over the Apalachicola National Forest just east of the property. TLH, rating, F1 estimated peak wind 90 miles per hour path length, or statute /21.4223 miles path width, or maximum /200.0 yards fatalities, 0 injuries, 0 start date, January 27, 2021 start time, 11:37 Eastern Standard Time start location, 2 West Andrew, or Leon County, or Florida start Lapland, 30.4074, or -84.4323 end date, January 27, 2021 end time, 12:02 p.m. Eastern Standard Time end location, 2WNW Cody, or Leon County, or Florida and Lapland, 30.3705, or -84.0763 survey summary, a tornado touchdown just west of the Tallahassee International Airport. The preliminary touchdown point is estimated by radar. Once the tornado reached the airport, it spun a CRJ plane 90 degrees and flipped the small Piper plane upside down. There was also damage to a few hangars with some small percentage of metal roofing uplifted. One hangar had large canvas doors on both sides that were shredded, with a support structure for one of the canvas doors wrenched free. A bit further east on the west end of the employee lot, one hardwood tree was uprooted and fell onto two cars. A few pine trees were snapped in the immediate vicinity. This one area had damage consistent with low-end F1 damage. The tornado may have lifted briefly as it tracked east-southeast across sparsely populated areas.
Oh my god.
It did snap a large branch on a tree near Crawfordville Road and Resnickel
Drive.
This is
not every transmitter.
There were several fence snapped along a half-mile stretch of tram road just west of Capitol Circle southeast. Many of these trees were likely weakened by Hurricane Michael.
Dang.
Damage was done to a few small trees along the southern periphery of the Southwood community, along Schumert Oak Boulevard and Four Oaks Boulevard. There were then sporadic instances of damage along Tram Road east of Southwood. Damage was then noted along St. Joe Road, with several trees snapped and uprooted there. Uprooted trees and minor property damage occurred on Foxtail Road and Bobby Goodwin Lane before the tornado lifted just west of the Jefferson County line. F scale. The enhanced Fujita scale classifies tornadoes into the following categories: F0, weak, 65 to 85 miles per hour; F1, weak, 86 to 110 miles per hour; F2, strong, 111 to 135 miles per hour; F3, strong, 136 to 165 miles per hour; F4, violent, 166 to 200 miles per hour; F5, violent, 200 miles per hour. Note, the information in this statement is preliminary and subject to change pending final review of the events and publication in National Weather Service storm data. These